Hello everyone. Today we'll be taking a look at how an Aria ban, better known as a chunk ban, functions. I will not be going over how to make one because it's very easy and you can find plenty of videos about that on YouTube. But first I would like to clear some common mistakes made around chunk bans. A chunk ban only works on multiplayer servers, not in single player. The range of a chunk ban varies. The effective range has nothing to do with chunk borders and its shape is a square. On a vanilla server, the range is 96. On a server with spigot/papermc software, it's 32. In addition, if a mob like a fox holds a shulker with high NBT data on a spigot/papermc server, then it will kick you within a range of 48 blocks. Shulker Explanation. The shulker box is filled with a lot of books containing Unicode characters. The most common character used for this is this. This character can add 77 bytes to the book. So if you were to completely fill a book with these, it would hold up to 157.09 kilobytes alone. Now when you fill a shulker with these books, it will exceed the 2.097152 megabyte limit. Code review, packet limit. Now let's take a look at how the game handles a shulker with this much data being on the ground, for example. This is handled in the size prepender file. The size prepender class is responsible for adding the size of the packet as a prefix before the actual data is sent over the network. This is an important step in network communication because it allows the receiver to know how much data is coming, which is crucial for correctly reading and processing the data. Now, what is the size limit on the packet and how is it set? As you can see, there is a constant which defines the maximum length of the size information in bytes that can be added to the packet. In this case, it is 3 bytes. Now you might be confused about the maximum prepend length being 3 bytes. Well, var ints are actually being used. Var ints are a way of encoding integer values using a variable number of bytes. In Minecraft's protocol, a var int can use between 1 and 5 bytes to represent values. 1 byte, for values 0 to 127. 2 bytes. For values 128 to 16,383. 3 bytes, for values 16,384 to 2,097,151. 4 bytes, for values 2,097,152 to 268,435,455. 5 bytes, for values 268,435,456. And as you can see, 3 bytes represents 16,384 to 2,097,151. And that's why the packet limit is 2,097,151 bytes, or 2.097151 megabytes. Client and server. Now what happens between the client and server that causes the client to be disconnected from the game when a packet is too large? 1. Packet size and serialization. Client side. When a client performs an action that generates data, like picking up a shulker box, this data is serialized into packets. Each packet has a specific size, which includes both the data and any metadata needed for the server to process it. Server side. The server needs to receive and process these packets. It expects packets to adhere to certain size limits to ensure efficient and safe processing. 2. Packet encoding and transmission. Encoding. Before the packet is sent, its size is encoded and prepended to the data using classes like size prepender. The size information helps the receiving end, the server, determine how much data to expect. Transmission. The client sends the encoded packet to the server over the network. 3. Server-side size validation. Receiving. When the server receives a packet, it first reads the size information, the length of the var int that was prepended. Size check. The server then checks if the size of the packet is within the acceptable limits. This involves several checks. Size limits in packet inflator. The server checks if the decompressed packet size exceeds the maximum allowed size. Size limits in size prepender. It checks if the size information itself can be represented within the allowed byte length. 4. Error handling and kicking. Exceeding limits. If any of the checks fail, meaning the packet size exceeds the maximum allowed size or the size information itself is too large, then the server throws an exception, such as decoder exception or encoder exception. Connection closure. when an exception related to packet size is thrown, indicating that the packet you attempted to send was too large, the server typically closes the connection with the client. This is why you get kicked from the server. Why does it not work in single player? I would quickly like to add an explanation on why area banning does not work in single player. As you will see, or as you have seen, area banning requires a network connection between the client and the server. But on a single player world, the data is managed locally. This removes the limitations related to data handling that exist in multiplayer, allowing the game to manage larger or more complex stuff directly.